My name's Hayden Ratner. I'm from Las Vegas, Nevada, and my story, my testimony is really a story of God's grace. It's a story of rescue, of being redeemed, and I'm thankful to be able to share it. My story really begins here in Las Vegas, Nevada, where I grew up. My mom is a Christian. My dad is Jewish. And so really they left it up to me of what I wanted to believe when it came to faith. So personally, I just believed in the basketball. That's what I did. I was a hooper. I still play the game. I still love the game. But early on in my life, that's really what I devoted my life to, playing basketball, and had this dream, this desire, this vision to be a Division I college basketball player and eventually be a professional basketball player. That's what my heart was set on. That was plan A. There was no plan B. And so I was working towards that all through middle school, through high school, going to different camps, playing at different tournaments, training with different coaches, just devoting myself to the game. Had an amazing high school basketball career. I gotta give God glory there, even though I didn't know Him at the time. I wasn't a Christian. I wasn't a believer in God as far as my actions and my lifestyle. I believed that God was up there. His name was Jesus. I just had no idea of who He actually was. And so I just grew up thinking that He was some white man who died on a cross, but had no reason for doing it. I didn't understand anything about the faith. I just lived my life. Never went to church, never opened a Bible, was too busy opening the gym shooting jump shots. And so I fast forward to 18 years old, getting ready to finish high school up, and I got a call from the head coach at James Madison University. And he wanted me to come take a visit and to check out their school and to perform in front of them. And I found myself in that spring of 2007 signing a letter of intent to play Division I college basketball at JMU. It was a dream come true. It was a blessing. It was all that I ever desired as far as me personally just wanting to play. And it's there. I'm there now. I'm playing college ball. I'm playing a lot as a freshman, which is awesome. Thousands of people in the crowd, right? Games on TV. We got all the gear, the clothes, the shoes, and I feel like this is all that I ever wanted. This is my dream. But something happened to me interesting one day when I came back from practice and I sat in my dorm room and I had this thought come into my mind. It was like, you know, I'm doing everything that I dreamed of. I'm doing everything I ever wanted to do, but I still have this emptiness inside. It's almost this longing that I'm looking for something that this can't provide. And I couldn't understand what it was. It was in that time I got invited to a ministry called FCA, Fellowship Christian Athletes. And I went and checked it out. And I noticed something different that night. There was a bunch of people who were there who looked like me, talked like me, dressed like me. They were athletes. But they had something different, and that was Jesus. They knew and had a personal relationship with Jesus. People were opening their Bible, lifting their hands to worship. And it was really more weird than anything for me. I'd never been in an atmosphere like that. And so I decided to check it out and to continue going. I came back the next week and had a conversation with a man named Joe, just a little bit more about the Bible, and he unpacked some scriptures for me. And I felt the Lord really start working in my life as I opened His Word. And it really came to a climax, I'd say, when I found myself reading the Gospel of Matthew and wound up in verse 21 of chapter 7. So I'm gonna read that real quick, and it's Jesus in the Sermon on the Mount, and what He says here, He says, "Not everyone who says to Me, 'Lord, Lord,' will enter the kingdom of heaven, but only the one who does the will of My Father who is in heaven. On that day, many will say to Me, 'Lord, Lord, didn't we prophesy in Your name, cast out demons in Your name, do many mighty works in Your name?' And then I, Jesus, will declare to them, 'Depart from Me, for I never knew you.'" And I read that, and that kind of blew up my whole world as far as thinking about God. I realized that day that not everyone's getting into heaven. Not everyone who just believes in God will wind up there. I thought if you just were a good person, that's where you'll be. And I realized that my idea of good was just me. I never thought about what God thought about good. It was just my own perception. And I'm realizing here that these are people that prophesied in God's name. They casted out demons. I never did anything like that. And Jesus was looking at him saying, "Depart from Me, for I never knew you." And it was in that moment that I realized that God doesn't desire for me to do things for Him. He desires for me to know Him. And so to have a relationship with Him, to grow with Him, to have this intimate fellowship with God, me and Him, where He knows me, I know Him, and we do life together. And I set my heart upon this journey that I'm gonna follow Jesus. I'm gonna get to know him. He's gonna get to know me. And then basketball kind of took the back seat. God kicked that idol off the throne of my heart, and he took that rightful place that I was created for. And so it was there in 2007 at JMU in my dorm room in Virginia that I surrendered my life to Jesus and began a relationship with him. I didn't know how everything was gonna work. I didn't know what was next. I just knew that I wanted him, that he died on the cross for my sin, that he rose from the grave and defeated death, and that I wanted to be a part of that. I wanted to be a part of the family of God. And I put my faith in him. I called out upon the Lord, and he saved me. From there, it was a great journey of still playing ball, but now I wasn't playing ball for myself and for my glory, but it was for him and his glory. Basketball wasn't a bad thing, it was a redeemed thing. It wasn't something that was now demonized and like, oh, basketball's the problem. It was more so, no, I get to play this game as a gift from God, for God. And that was awesome. That was something that I won. That was freeing, because now I got to leave the games playing bad or playing good. I was free because my identity was found in Christ and not in myself. As you fast forward a few years later, I graduated from a school called Mercyhurst University with a religious studies degree. Finished up my playing days there. I was blessed with the opportunity to go over to Israel and play a year of professional basketball there, which was amazing. Learned so much there, got to play at a high level, and lived that dream. God still allowed me to live the dream of playing professional basketball, but what was amazing was it was in his holy land. Got to experience a lot of the places where Jesus actually walked, the Sea of Galilee, the Dead Sea, Jerusalem, the Sermon on the Mount, right? We were there in those places, got to experience those, and go with my wife as well, Nina. And so we've been on this journey, my wife and I, as we've moved back to Las Vegas, of planting this church that God's given us a vision of. And so now we're about 7 weeks in planting Walk Church, which comes from Colossians chapter 2, verse 6, which says, therefore, as you have received Christ Jesus the Lord, walk in him. And so what we want to do is we don't want to just receive Jesus, then leave Jesus. But we want to actually walk in him. So that same God that met me in my dorm room at James Madison University, you know, 5-6 years ago, is that same God that we're called to walk in every day. And we have a heart for Las Vegas. We want to see the city redeemed. We want to see local basketball players here in the city come to know Jesus and have their sport redeemed. We want to see people rescued by grace, just how God rescued us. And that's the whole desire behind Walk Church. That's the desire behind myself and my wife. We want to be used for the glory of God. And this is our story of what he did in me and what he's doing through me. So I'm thankful to be able to share it. God is good. Let him be the glory. And let's press on in our walk in him.